Hey everyone, it's Ivan. KipAtcher.com out here for a first look. Some new stuff I got in from Sitka, as well as Ate gear, whatever it is, as well as Brownells. Even though it's sunny out, we're going to start with this stuff from Sitka because it's like 28 degrees out right now. And I'm pretty sure there's something warm inside of here, which is awesome because it is not warm right now. Turning clothing into gear. That's what this actually says. Nice. All right, so this is the Traverse hoodie in Storm. It's like a soft shell, I think. And then, again, because it's not very warm, we'll go with this one, which is their Kelvin Light Down Jacket. I'm gonna put this on right now. Already warmer. I'll be honest, I thought this was like a higher loft piece. It's not, but yeah, it's definitely already warmer. So I should probably check this one out too. All right, change of plans. I'm gonna wear this one. This one is definitely not compressible like the other one. Not as high of a loft, but it does have this like nice soft fleece inside. And I'm pretty sure, not that it's windy, but this will probably cut wind also. So, all right, on to Adi, whatever, the other one. Well, Sitka has gotten pretty big kind of in the outdoor hunting world. Like they have their own lines of camo and their whole like layering system. Adi does a lot of cool stuff. They actually have a number of different layering pieces, but they also make some different gear. And I think this is actually their new chest rig. Sticker pack, elastic insert for looks like 5.56-ish. Pretty sure this is the harness. Some of these pretty cool clips. Looks like pistol mag inserts. And then this guy right here. Cool. So it's a chassis style. So there's a larger compartment here, another compartment up front. It looks like some Velcro closures for all kinds of things. So it's been a minute getting this thing hooked up, or set up rather, and then yeah, do some shooting. Alright, I can configure this a lot of ways. I'm gonna run it like this. Basically, with all these different pieces, yeah, you can do all kinds of stuff. But so I have it set up for a full flap up front, basically an enclosed compartment, and then the back, room for three mags. Got these things on, they're pretty cool. They're kind of like, they're kind of akin to like first beer tubes. And I'll probably need to size this stuff up a little bit more. But time to jam some mags, do a little bit of shooting. All right, everyone loves a good comeback story. So here we are, Brownells BRN 180 in 7.62x39. And yeah, gonna get this thing going. Also got one of their high power springs for it. When they first came out with these, they ran into some issues. I had some issues with it, as well as a few other people. And they're like, all right, let's make this right. Took them all back and I think they got it sorted out now. Took this out once yesterday, I guess, just to get it zeroed. Have the AEMS, I believe, on it by HoloSun, and this giant old, I think it's by CGS Hyperion QD, even though it's direct thread. And yeah, it got sent out a while ago, and then they promptly like changed the entire design, so it's a completely different can now. But gonna do a little bit of shooting with this and yeah, see how it does. My target just fell down. I should probably fix that. Since someone left these drums out here, how about a little bit of lateral movement? Couple misses, cause it happens. How about a minivan? All right, let's do this thing. Sweet, sweet minivans. Also, if you're wondering about that, there's a funny story behind that. The last time I had this BRN 180S, and I was doing some shooting with it, didn't have a can on it, and these little guys, don't worry about those little guys, was literally shooting. I'm like, phew, good press, and I see it hit up on the berm. I'm like, maybe I was off. Slow it down, good press, hits high. I'm like, there's no way. Slow it down third time, good press. Yep. Now I'm like, okay, I'm not that screwed up. And I wasn't, other than I was so screwed up, I was basically skipping them off. That, fortunately, 7.62 by 39, pretty rounded. Pretty sure if that was 5.56, it would have just punched through my hood. Instead, it just gives this minivan a little bit of character. And it was a learning point. Definitely shot vehicles in the past, on purpose and on accident. Just never my vehicle, but whatever. Daily driver. All right, let's do this. All the dust. Give it to me. Man, it's so bright. That, however, will not buff out. Damn it. Well, that's what I get. Nailed it. It's okay. They're just grazing wounds. Get a little touch-up paint, be good as new. I'm like, how did that happen? So the first ones I shot here, and the second ones I shot further back right here, which was just enough to get the rise. Banana clip. Winning. Well, I'm honestly pretty stoked with all this stuff. As I put in more time with it, both the layers, as well as this little chest rig, and BRN 180 in 7.62x39, really stoked that Brownells was able to, looks like, get that squared away. So yeah, as I put in more time, I'll bring you reviews on all of it, but yeah, pretty fun time out here. And as always, thanks for joining us at kitbadger.com. Look forward to seeing you next time.